The 60s brought the hippie breed, and decades later things have changed indeed. We lost the values, but we kept the weed. You've got a lot to see. The Reagan years have laid the frame for movie stars to play the White House game. We're not too far from voting Feldman-Haim. You've got a lot to see. The town of Vegas has got a different face, 'cause it's a family place with lots to do. Where in the 50s a man could mingle with scores of all the seediest whores, well, now his children can too. You heard it from the canine's mouth. The country's changed, that is, except the South, and you'll agree. No one really knows, my dear lady friend, just quite how it all will end. So hurry, 'cause you've got a lot to see. The baldness gene was cause for dread, but that's a fear that you can put to bed. They'll shave your ass and glue it on your head. You've got a lot to see. The PC age has moved the bar. A word like redneck is a step too far. The proper term is country music star. You've got a lot to see. Our flashy cell phones make people mumble gee whiz. Look how important he is. His life must rule. You'll get a tumor, but on your surgery day, the doc will see it and say, wow, you must really be cool. There's lots of things you may have missed,
like Pee-wee at his famous wrist,
or Sandy Duncan's creepy phony eye,
that awesome Thundercat cartoon,
Neil Armstrong landing on the moon.
Neil Armstrong? Wait, was he the trumpet guy?
So let's go see the USA. They'll treat you right unless you're black or gay or Cherokee. But you can forgive the world and its flaws and follow me there, because you've still got a hell of a lot to see. You've got a lot to see.
Let's see it. A 5, 6, 7, 8. Who's got the greatest gal around?
You do. Who's got the sweetest man in town?
You do.
Who's got a guy who makes her smile all day?
By the way, I'm not so bad to look at either.
Who's got a guy with lots of brains?
You do. Who's got a girl who loves chow mein?
You do.
Who's got the greatest love in the world?
You do.
And you do. Thank goodness I've got you.
Who's got a guy to tell her jokes?
You do. Who's got a girl to show the folks?
You do.
Who's got a girl he'd like to one day undress?
Give it a rest. I told you not until we're married.
Who's got the gal with all the snazz?
You do. Who's got the fella with the zazz?
You do. Who's got the greatest love in the world?
You do.
And you do. Thank goodness I got you.
Watch this. Are you watching? That's for me ever having doubted you. A plus. And that's for you wearing purple pants with blue socks.
And I are so awfully different, too awfully different to ever be pals.
Do you want to go first?
Yeah, I'll go.
Your favorite hero is the Marquis de Sade.
Do you want to talk?
You'll get a stiffy from Felicia Rashad.
For one time.
I've a style flair. Just look at my hip hair.
Oh, yeah, that's quite a nice do there.
Oh, thanks.
For me to poop on.
What?
Oh, come on, you look like Charlie Brown.
Bite me, Snoopy.
There's not a whole lot that we've got to agree on.
'Cause I love the strains of a club. classical score.
And I like that singer who looks like a whore.
Ricky Martin.
Love him.
We're too different to ever be pals. You and I are so awfully different. Too awfully different to ever be pals. Your head's as massive as a meteorite.
Very funny. You have a weenie like a Christmas tree light.
I'd bet money you'll marry a honey who's pretty and funny, and her name will be Ted.
I'll gauge you.
I just work with what you give me.
You might think we're in sync, but we stink as a duo. 'Cause you get a kick out of carnage and guts.
And you get a kick out of stroking your...
Whoa, you can't say that on TV.
What, ego?
Never mind.
We're too different to ever be pals.
I hated this movie as much as any movie we've ever reviewed in the 19 years we've been doing this show. I hated it because of the premise, which seems shockingly cold-hearted, and because this premise is being suggested to kids as children's entertainment, and because everybody in the movie was vulgar and stupid, and because the jokes weren't funny, and because most of the characters were obnoxious, and because of the phony attempt to add a little pseudo-hip philosophy with a Bruce Willis character.